G'day, it's Bergs, and this is the Roland Blues Cube Hot. This is a Gibson SG. As you can see, it's got some Tyson Tone PAFs in it, and they're kind of lowish output, but they are pumping the hell out of this little amp, and this little amp is pumping the hell out of the room and the surrounding neighbourhood. The Blues Cube is a 30-watt amp, which you can attenuate down to 5 watts, 15 watts, and half a watt. It's based on the circuit of a bassman, and they use a new technology called Tube Logic, which is kind of the next step up from COSM, I guess, that Roland initiated, nearly 30 years ago, 20 years ago, I'm not quite sure. It's obviously solid state. They've got a custom 12-inch speaker in there, which has the right sort of dynamics, and it does actually have the bounce and the sag, if you pump the volumes hard enough, of a classic 59 Tweed bassman. I've owned a couple of clones, and it's pretty damn close, considering the size. It only weighs 12 kgs or 27 pounds in the old language, so it's really light, and it's really loud. Let's have a listen to it then, starting from scratch. I'll go from about noon with everything. Except for the reverb. We'll turn the reverb off, all right? So it's clean, but there's a little bit of break up there that's sounding really good to my ears. Of course, if I crank the volume, it's going to get a lot more broken up. And then if I hit the boost, it's going to drive the preamp even harder, and I'll take the volume back to 12 and we'll show you how that works. Now that sounds almost JTM45 crank to me. If I go harder with the volume, classic tones. Fang it with the volume. I'll go to the neck pickup and we'll just start with the volume wound down a bit. And check where the controls are. Get the idea? There's also a tone boost here, which kind of enhances the top end. Both the boost and the tone can be turned off via a remote foot switch, which you can get from Roland or any number of other companies. Let's have a look at this reverb now. I'll just leave the controls at noon, so we'll go to the middle pickup position just for something different, huh? Plenty of wet drippiness happening there. On the rear, you will find a headphone output, a line output, and also a USB 2 output, so you can record direct to your DAW, your DAW, your digital audio workstation. And of course, the most important thing, perhaps, for some, will be this power attenuation, which I'll just crank all these the master and the volume and show you how it works. So here's 30 watt. It is loud as hell in here. Here's 15. And here's 5. So we're not actually losing any of the tone. We're only losing the sound pressure level, which is good because my ears are screaming now. Right, so that's at a half or what? Now that means I can crank everything, including the boost here. Might as well gun the tone controls too, hey? We'll come up to a big 5 watts. Watts. Wow. And that's getting almost unbearably loud in here, so I'm not even going to go to 30. It's a ripper amp. It's light. It's small. It's got the sounds. I'm not sure what more you could want. It's made by Roland, a company with a huge reputation. It's the Roland Blues Cube Hot. Highly recommended. This one is not going back to Roland. It is staying right here. Thanks very much. I'll see you guys later.